With the release of Season 7, we now have 7 seasons inside of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., so today, I thought it was time for me to stop and rank all 7 seasons of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. from the worst to the best. Hey everyone, S-Dub Nation here, and if you like this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll post some more Marvel videos. Please note that everything that I will say in this video is just my very own opinion. My list is certainly not the right list, it is just my list, and you are free to comment down below. What did you think of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., Season 7, or the series, or even just rank your seasons from worst to best just like me, or you could just do your favorite. Like, comment, and subscribe, and without further ado, let's get into the ranking. Kicking off my list at number 7, we have Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Season 6. This season is all about filler. It was mostly just filler in my opinion, and I really did not enjoy that. But I do really enjoy the Fitzsimmons relationship and the Enoch stuff. I feel like Enoch is actually a great character, has a fascinating character arc, and one of the best characters inside of the show. I love the fact that May and Coulson's relationship is put front and center with the Sarge stuff, and the Sarge stuff is kind of cool, but not needed. And Mac as the director makes for a lot more diversity, but I don't see myself rewatching this season anytime soon. Coming in at 6th place, we have Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Season 2. The Inhuman storyline works for the MCU, and also this season kind of ties into Age of Ultron and makes both the show and the movie better. Daisy's mom had a nice motivation and a great character arc, but I wasn't interested. I do enjoy some of the ideas in the Inhumans coming into the mix, while also expanding the team and the character arcs, and also the relationships between them. But I'm definitely not going to rewatch this. Maybe some episodes though. Most of them are actually pretty nice. Kicking off my top 5 list has got to go to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Season 7. This is the last season of the series that ends bittersweetly and very enjoyable for diehard fans. This season incorporates what we know about time travel from Endgame by using the Quantum Realm and uses that to their advantage. This season pulls everything together in a satisfying way and is very emotional. But I found this season confusing and complicated and sometimes boring. Not saying the finale or the season or even the series is god-awful, just saying it's not my cup of tea. But for the show, it had turned into, it works. Before I get into my top 4, I'd like to take the time to say that if you are a fan of Marvel, which you probably are, that's why you're watching this video, click that playlist up above for everything Marvel related that I have on my channel. Also, if you are a fan of the MCU, I am doing an MCU rewatch on my podcast. It's called The Regular Podcast, and that link is always in the description and in the comment section, and we will be uploading Captain America Civil War on Monday. Without further ado, let's get into my top 4. At number 4, we have Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Season 1. Though it may start off slow, it just becomes so interesting in the mystery of Tahiti, and we have more character development from our fan favorite Coulson, which he has one of the best scenes maybe in the entire series. It's like later down in the season, but he has just a great emotional scene, and you actually get to see Clark's Greg acting perfectly. And just seeing S.H.I.E.L.D. fall from the perspective of the agents, and actually seeing the agents behind S.H.I.E.L.D., like actually seeing the humans, actually seeing the people, actually seeing the interactions, like the relationships inside of the team, inside of the agents themselves, just seeing them together makes this season better. And also seeing the betrayal of one of their own makes the series future bright. And from episode 10, I was hooked. Another thing that I love about this season is that it is very connected to the MCU. It has ties to Thor: The Dark World and Captain America: The Winter Soldier, and things that happen in that movie affect this series and affect this season particularly as a whole, and makes this show a whole lot better. And I guess that's where I kind of got interested when I finally saw Nick Fury and we get to see more ties to Captain America: The Winter Soldier or Thor: The Dark World. Just having that bridge connection to the MCU makes this season a whole lot better. Kicking off my top 3 list has got to go to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Season 5. Season 5 is actually a tricky one for me because I enjoy Season 1 a lot more. It has a great space arc though, and it is just so amazing. The space arc is just phenomenal, but I do think that this is where the show kind of fell off for me after the space arc when they returned back to Earth, but in the past. And it's just so confusing, and anytime you're dealing with time travel, you find plot holes and convoluted plot lines. But the Fitzsimmons stuff is great. Once again, we have an Infinity War reference, but Infinity War doesn't reference the agents. And then we also have that space arc, phenomenal space arc. And then Enoch. Enoch and Deke are great additions to the team, and I love that. But that space arc, just them in that contest of champions-like type thing with the Kree. And then we also have them trying to break out of prison, trying to get back to Earth. Just a lot of things that I love about this season, but it has to come in at number 3 because it just gets so boring when we get back to Earth. Our runner-up at number two, we have Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Season 3. This is prime Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. for me because they are all here. The entire team is here, including Grant Ward, which I loved. Grant Ward is a great character. Nobody can tell me different. They work in the field more. The relationships are being forged and rebuilt. This is the only season besides Enoch's death in Season 7 where I cried due to the spy's goodbye. Because you buy into their family relationship, and I found this season to be worthy of a 100% on Rotten Tomatoes and easily better than some MCU movies. But coming in at my number one has got to go to Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Season 4. Everything about this season is S tier. It has a great villain, excellent writing and directing, two great arcs that come together in full circle in the end, the Ghost Rider arc and also the LMD arc. I love the can't trust anyone LMD arc, and it makes sense for a spy show. Everything that happens here has consequences for the team and the series. I don't think I was ever this invested into a Marvel show since Daredevil. This is definitely S tier, 100%, 10 out of 10, A+++, and obviously better than most Marvel movies. Not some, most Marvel movies, and I would rewatch this season any day of the week, anytime, because it is just so perfect and amazing and fits the spy formula. This is why Season 4 of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. has to come in at number 1. Alright guys, that is it for the ranking. Please know that everything that I did say in this video was just my very own opinion. My list was certainly not the right list, it was just my list, and you are free to comment down below. What did you think of Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. Season 7 as a whole? What did you think of the series? Rank your seasons from worst to best just like me, or you could just do your favorite. And how do you feel that the show is finally ended? I know it ended off bittersweetly because I was never really a big fan of the show, but I do understand a lot of people pain with it that this is the show that was just the best of the MCU shows, but I personally think Daredevil is kind of better. Alright, I'm going to leave on that note because I may have caused a lot more controversy than I actually intended to. So, on that note, like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.